Right, Dave, why don't you introduce your crew? Go on.
I will do.
It's like Blazing Squad, like a better version of Blazing Squad.
There's only three of us, like JLS.
Go on, you do the honours.
There were four of them. There were four of them.
Four, yeah.
Well, are we running?
Yeah, yeah, we're running, we're running.
Is it a band? Three people.
Yeah, we're running, mate.
All right, anyway. This is Danny Morrell.
I know Danny.
The Yorkshire Light Middleweight Champion.
Yeah. Soon to be national.
Pre-quarter-finals week on Sunday. This is Liam Kerrigan. He's had his first fight on December 7th.
Hello, mate.
Hey, the fourth member of our band is Darren Barker, the former IBF Middleweight Champion in the world.
I've got a good chat with the
Hello.
All right. So, that's amazing squad, aren't they,
these lot? Yeah, they are.
So, yeah, this is the team. This is it. Yeah, right, yeah.
Just witness the weigh-ins there, man. It's a good show. Obviously, there's some great fights on the bill, but a lot of people in Manchester have come here for Anthony Crawley. I know you're here for, you know, the Doncaster connection as well.
I'm here for Terry.
Yeah.
I think Cullen and Cash is the fight of the night. I think Darren Barker is very immature for 42.
Is he filming us?
He's filming me.
I'm watching.
But I think Crawley's been a great servant to the sport, you know, and he deserves his send-off. You know, the fight, it shouldn't be a grueler, you never know, you never say never, it could turn out to be a hard night, but I think he deserves this this send-off. So yeah, but overall it's an okay show.
Yeah, fair enough. And, you know, in terms of the outcome of that fight, Cullen and Cash.
What do you think of Cullen and Cash? He likes his no-face tattoo. He's a big fan of Cullen since he saw it.
Well, now I remember who he is.
So on that basis, you're going for Cullen, are you? Yeah, on tattoo basis?
Yeah, definitely. We watched him at Newcastle, wasn't it?
Liverpool.
Yeah, I thought
he was really good. He got performance against Harding Jr., didn't he?
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
Enjoyed it.
How do you see it going then, Danny?
I haven't really seen enough of the other fella to say, so...
I'll tell you, because I've seen him both.
He's seen him both, so he's the boxer.
I think Cash is a very, very good, well-schooled boxer. Yeah. However, Cullen's very awkward, very fit, very long. It could go either way. That's a real 50-50. And I think Terry and Oberhof's a 50-50
as well. That's a really good fight, yeah.
I think they're both 50-50s. Taylor and Crawler are here to showcase their skills, and I think they'll have easy wins. Bacoli. The fella who's boxing is built like a Lego block, so he must be tough.
He's built like a Lego block, yeah.
You know, like short and square. Yeah, yeah. And like, he's weighing 18-10, he's only about 4'7", mental.
How would you say you're built?
Like a brick shit house.
Correct.
Yeah.
What's going on with you at the minute then, man? Because actually, I'm looking at you now and actually, you know, you've got a bit of a glow about yourself.
Yeah. You know what, I'm just enjoying my life at the minute. I'm training Danny at the minute, like Danny's fighting next Sunday, he could become national champion in 4 weeks' time. And when I met him, he was dog shit. So,
it's true though. I wasn't great.
Well, you had him sparring you at workouts, didn't you?
He'd won eight and lost about 30. And I said, Danny, come here son, because you can fight you and I'll show you how it's done. And you do it. And look at him now, top 16 in country. If he wins the next fight, he's top 8 in country. He's 4 fights away from being the best fighter at 17, 18 years old in the country.
Oh, fair play to you. Your progress has been, you know, steady.
Unbelievable. So much graft he's put in, like, you can take an horse to water, but he's been fucking gulping it down, let me tell you. The same with Liam as well, Liam's first fight on the 7th of December. You know, Liam's turned his whole life around, he's done fantastic. He'll tell you more about it himself.
Are you looking forward to it, mate?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So I've ever done it.
It's alright, that's happened to me twice today.
Nearly not necking it, nearly getting injured.
Yeah.
Nah, still just got to do better, do good, haven't we, lads?
What's it like working with the big man himself?
Nah, it's brilliant, it's an honour. Can drag you out of bed, get you there on time, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Good inspiration.
I do drag him out of bed some days as well.
Yeah.
Some days I have to physically shout him 12 times. I said something the other day, I shouted him 12 times. The 13th time I went, oh my God, he's dead. I was about to ring him and say, oh my God, Liam's dead. But luckily he was alive, he was just asleep.
That is a turn up for the books. And lads, do you give Dave a bit of a push to get in the gym as well?
We tried to, yeah, well, he's his own man.
At the minute, he's going for it at the minute, so...
Yeah, well, that's what I've been hearing you going for it at the minute, Dave. And,
no, I'll tell you what, people text me, message me online, do you want to spar? And I go, well, come down and spar. It's been doing sparring.
It's all about enjoying yourself.
Taking these on the pads and joining with little bits like they're doing. I'm keeping fit, my weight's down. As soon as Eddie rings me and says, look, you can fight him for the same money you got for Dubois, I'm good to go. Until then, I'm happy to semi-retire training these. Yeah. When the right fight comes, I'll dust me my gloves off. And
you're taking over, you're doing what you need to do.
I'm getting myself into a position where I'm ready to go for, if I've got 8 or 10 weeks notice, basically. Yeah. I'm not ready to fight in 8 weeks now. But give me 4 or 5 weeks and I will be, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah, it makes sense.
You get a 12-week camp, you're 4 weeks getting your weight off and getting fit, and you've got 8 weeks to train. If you give me 8 weeks right now, I've got 4 weeks to get fit and only got 3 weeks to prepare. Does that make sense?
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah. Dave, I'm getting a few boxers to give a little message to Anthony Connell. Can I ask you to do a little message for Anthony Connell?
I don't know Anthony Connell. I've met him once or twice. He was a gent. However, as a boxing fan, what a great fighter he's been. I can first remember Crawler boxing Gary Sykes in the prize fighter and Yusuf Al-Hamidi. He lost to Yusuf Al-Hamidi, and then he's gone on to win world titles. He is an inspiration to fighters like me who've had early career defeats. He's an inspiration to anybody, really, what he's achieved. Well, the greatest thing I always say is he's built a fan base, and there's nothing more amazing than having thousands of people support you.
You know, mate.
Yeah, I know, and I can't fight half as good as him. He's done both, so good man. You know, no good fighter, even better man, I'd probably say. So yeah, I hope he has a great night tomorrow and all goes to plan.
Nice one. Well, listen, whatever you end up doing, mate, in the coming months, best of luck in it. Good luck to your squad. 21 seconds to go.
See you later on.
Yeah.